Last season, Judy introduced us to something called color puncture.
That's right, Olivia. Color puncture is a combination of acupuncture and light therapy.
Its practitioners say color puncture can tap into the part of the brain that regulates our energy system to help us stay balanced and healthy.
Now color puncture is being used to help vets returning from Iraq and Afghanistan.
Dennis Telfer was a port security chief for the U.S. Coast Guard. His assignments included duty in Kuwait and an oil terminal called Maybot off the coast of Iraq.
This is just a firing position from Maybot again. We had weapons set up all around the half-mile-long terminal, and we would stand those posts 24 hours a day. This is temporary living conditions at Ashwaba, which is the maritime port north of Kuwait Naval Base. The extra heavy suits we're wearing is because those are what's called MOP suits. Those are our chemical biological protective suits. And this is just simply an example of a sandstorm. During a sandstorm, this is what I would wear. You would do anything you could. Exposed skin felt like it was being sandblasted. This is back at Kuwait Naval Base. This was a daily occurrence during the height of the war. When the air raid siren sounded, we all had to put our gas masks on.
But Dennis came back from his time in Iraq and Kuwait with more than just war zone pictures.
I was actually struck in the back of the head with a machine gun. It wasn't even in combat. It's just, I got hit in the head with people moving equipment around. But it caused a neck injury. And so it was always stiff and hard to move about and so forth.
While Dennis was in Iraq, he sustained some contusions to his neck. And he has some pain in his neck.
On this day, Dennis is receiving a color puncture treatment. It's a combination of acupuncture and color therapy, and it's being administered by Rosemary Bourne in San Rafael, California. She's one of several hundred color puncture practitioners in the U.S.
And I'm using the light green that will allow the muscle to heal and regenerate.
I have doctors who would say, well, we can go in and cut this and cut that. I'm not a big fan of that. Okay, so without invasive surgery, I've gotten my mobility back, and I've got the pain reduction, and I'm a happy camper.
More difficult than the physical problems were the mental scars that Dennis brought home with him, including many symptoms of post-traumatic stress disorder.
The first counselor I walked to, when I told her that I'm suffering from stress from the war in the last 2 years at that time of traveling around the world doing different things, she looked at me and said, well, you just need to buck up and get over it.
Color puncture is based on the work of Peter Mandel, a German naturopathic physician. Its goal is to tap into the part of the brain that regulates the energy systems in our body.
And what we found is that people with highly traumatized nervous systems tend to have a predominance of beta brain waves, which is these hyperarousal waves.
Technically, I self-diagnosed the PTSD. When I first came back, heavy alcohol drink, angry about nothing, poor decisions, tossed away a perfectly good relationship with a woman at the time for no particular reason, blaming others for this and that. All the symptoms were there, all the lack of good functionality was there, and so that's why I started back then, trying to find help.
It's a really good thing that now he's starting to feel that the theta waves are coming on board, because this means that his system is starting to down-regulate.
I was a hard-charging chief in the Coast Guard. That was a great persona, but in your private life and your private relationships, you know, you don't need to be quite so hard. And I was. Just still some stress coming over from years of experiences that needed to be kind of resolved and worked over.
And what this treatment does, it allows the system to de-stress by regulating the pituitary hypothalamic bundle, and it also allows for the increase in the neurotransmitters of serotonin and dopamine. And serotonin is very especially important for problems with depression or anger.
Yes, there was a lot of anger, and it wasn't the old going postal type of anger. It's more of a low-grade one. It's, you don't understand why this is making you mad. This doesn't make other people mad. Why am I mad about this or that?
So when people have post-traumatic stress disorder, or any kind of stress, the way that it impacts the brain initially is it creates stress on the pituitary hypothalamic bundle. And then what it does is it disturbs the release of hormones into the body, and this has an effect on the emotions, and it also has an effect on the whole autonomic functioning of the system.
During the therapy and through all the sessions I've had with Rosemary, you know, I don't get angry much anymore. Not like I used to, okay? It's just, it's a whole different thing now.
Dennis says the tools and techniques of color puncture have been a big part of helping him reintegrate into civilian life. And he says he's by no means the only returning soldier who could use this help.
I'm a big proponent of any stress reduction programs for soldiers coming back. We train them up to be soldiers and to fight hard in foreign countries, but we do very little to reprogram to be good citizens back here again. And so programs like this are excellent ways to do it. I'd like to see the government do much more for bringing our soldiers back and helping them resolve those stressful issues of the life that they've led for the last 2, 3, 4 years.
Is color puncture being used elsewhere to help returning vets, Roy?
It is indeed. Rosemary says other therapists are getting very good results in dealing with post-traumatic stress.
If you'd like to learn more about color puncture and where you can find a practitioner in your area, we have the link for you on the Healing Quest website.